And maybe once he stops rumbling around in his hotel, we can start.
Oh. Well, that's just about the most suggestive thing you've ever said to me.
Oh, hey, we're live. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so it's been a while. We have kind of been behind schedule on the Tora North American VAG Trophy, and Ben is actually not in his current location. He is somewhere else in the United States.
Yeah, I'm traveling to visit family, so I won't be able to actually see the replay except for what I can see on the little preview window that Zeta has provided for me. So,
all right, so we're going to cover rounds 2 and 3 with whatever replays we can find. Ben has provided the coverage for Nürburgring Grand Prix, and then we're going to jump right to Suzuka via Yellowy Chief. So, while we get that loaded up, is there anything in particular I need to be worried about, Ben?
I'm trying to think back. This was almost a month ago. There's a couple of battles that do take place, especially towards the front in A lobby. I'm not sure about A class. I'm not sure about B class. There might have been a couple of things. Probably the most interesting thing about this race is going to be Yoi Chief and a Colonel switching to go down to B class after they're having some issues with the Bora in the A class during the Silverstone race.
Also, shout out to both the Colonel and Yellowy Chief for providing some interesting racing here at Silly Stone, and thank you for messaging me some time back. So hopefully, we'll see something again.
Yeah.
Alrighty. So, to remind everybody that we're only going to be live streaming the North American version of the VAG Trophy, Tora staff will be covering the UK version, which will be on Motors TV.
Very exciting.
Why not?
Yeah.
Well, the only thing they're getting from me is photos, and I'm sure I'm probably going to get asked if I've done Laguna Seca. That's okay. We should be all caught up by tomorrow, rounds 4 and 5, and then we'll just see what happens from there.
Yep. Alrighty. There'll be some very interesting action in C lobby between me and River Merc for you to cover.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty.
Not to provide any spoilers, but we were side-by-side going down the corkscrew at more than one point, so.
Spoilers.
Yep.
Alrighty, so the grid will be setting up after qualifying. So, right now we're just going to jump ahead to HCR Solar, who recently has purchased a capture card and... Or no way, he just got an Xbox One and is live streaming.
There you go, yeah. I can't think of his stream name at the moment, but shout out to Solar and his no-scope sponsorship.
Are you saying he's part of the MLG now?
No, the no-scope getting glasses that sponsored the... whatever was it, the no-scope Mugello 5000? Or 5000? 500?
That was the no-scope Mugello 500. Also, 500. Looks like Solar is having some lockup lag, as his rear tires are...
Actually, Solar is doing that on purpose. For some whatever reason, the way the Scirocco handles, your rear tires don't get warm unless you hold your handbrake down and spin them so... Well, not spin. You drag them so they warm up. So you get a better launch.
Well, I've
been doing the same thing.
Fair enough. Well, yeah. It's definitely lag, but without further ado, we should do the starting grid here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, starting on the pole, HCR Solar. And next to him will be Skoda Boy. In row 2 will be Contrate Hurdle and Big Ben, who's providing the lobby replay footage. In row 3 is Lone Wolf 8646, beautiful 4 out of 4 drift. And next to him, Mr. Shaded to you. In row 4, the last row for today of this group is Hujdongle 87 and Gator 383. Now for the lower tier class, we have a Colonel. Next to him will be LG. In row 2 is EZT Mondo 6669. And next to him will be EZT Coot. And in last place by his lonesome is Tyrannic Symbols. That concludes your team. Class grid here at Nürburgring. Alrighty, so since there will be a lot of stuff taking place up in the higher class. Is there anything in particular we should be careful of in the lower class?
Like I said earlier, I really can't. Sorry for bumping my mic. I can't really remember if there was a lot of battling going on in the lower class. I got involved in my own battle here, which you'll see in a couple minutes. So I wasn't really paying attention for what they were doing.
All right, and for those who are wondering why the in-game audio is low, that is because for some reason Roxio will reduce the volume quality when there is a Skype call taking place.
Because reasons.
Because stupid capture card.
Mm-hmm.
And because reasons. All right, so we're watching. Now this is A class, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Now, I can understand the start-finish line being the most confusing here at Nurburgring GP because there are two lines, and if I'm not mistaken, it's going to be the red-white border up front as the start-finish line.
I just broke my necklace.
Hi, Mom. Oh, where was I? Okay, we're still lining up here. Yeah, I can't quite remember. We just kind of ran with the whole 25-foot rule and had Solar get as close to the line as possible.
Well,
just so we could get lined up here.
Because of that, no one is exactly lined up where the starting grid markers are. As we can see, the outside row is kind of...
Yeah.
Not in place.
Yeah, what are you going to do? Solar also chose that side to start the race on, just because he gets a little bit of a better line through turn one, that evil, evil turn one.
It is a sharp
and makes
line.
Everyone on the inside of the corner have to work on it, keeping it tight so that he doesn't try to destroy us or anything like that.
Well, green flag is out, and we begin the first lap of seven here at the Nürburgring Grand Prix, and Solar gets the lead. Swear, getting used to the higher revs of the cars, it feels like this is taking forever. Oh, battle for the lead between Skoda Boy and Solar.
Yeah, that's going to be happening a lot.
Well, we'll try to focus on the other positions as much as possible when they give us a break.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah, I had a horrible start at the beginning of this race, so I actually have dropped back into what is now sixth position on the field, and I'm going to be fighting with Lone Wolf for a while.
As of late, you are currently in fifth place, so Lone Wolf is
okay.
Ahead of you by one.
I meant fifth.
It's okay.
Cars.
It's been a while since you've raced here at Nürburgring, so it's, mm-hmm. it's okay. No one's going to hurt you yet. Just gonna go through the field here and see what's happening. Back of A class, not much. It looks like something's shaping up in the B class division between EZT Mako, Yellowy Chief, and EZT Coot.
Yeah, these four have been really close together basically every round of the series of that we've raced since here. So they're definitely making B class very interesting to watch.
Now, for those who did not know, there is a Volkswagen Beetle in the UK division. Only one driver has been using it, so it's not just Scirocco's and Golf GTIs.
I am driving, actually, a Volkswagen Rabbit in the UK version, as well as doing this races.
That's good. And for those who did not know, I believe rumor has it that CQR did not attend round 5 in the UK version, which is a shocker.
Mm-hmm.
Which means I'm going to have to find someone else for the replays for fellow taking purposes. One phase. Now it looks like B-Class is starting to distance themselves from each other. a little battle shaping up between a Gator and a Colonel, as that little Audi TT manages to get by in 7th place. Call it a little TT because it is a tiny car.
It is a very tiny car.
It is.
It's a tiny Audi. I believe at this point is when my battle with Glomglove started to heat up a little bit. And basically Skoda and Skoda and Solar combined their gaming tags there for a second, are basically going at it basically the entire race.
Oh, fun little fact.
Basically.
Solar Flare's gamer tag is based off one of these special attacks in Dragon Ball Z, so it's okay to make a fusion reference.
Yeah.
Hashtag Solar.
Please don't get that trending.
I got Fish Position trending. And Vet Fest.
Oh, boy.
Hashtag Vet Fest.
Well, this is Nurburgring, so you might as well start speaking in that voice.
Look. Okay, so we're watching the Lone Wolf and the Big Ben going down onto the backstretch. Nothing happening. You lied to me.
Well, you missed my pass then. Gosh.
What a fail.
I did not fail. I got by. You failed.
I am not.
Actually, I do feel here in a couple minutes.
Sure.
I believe it's this lap that I actually lock up going to the first corner and he gets by me again.
Meanwhile, up in front, Skoda Boy still leads, but Solar in second place. These two are very close to one another, very close enough that they almost made contact before hitting turn one. And Contre Hurl has nobody to team up with.
Yeah. Yep, that's my fail.
Even though you failed, you're still ahead.
Yeah, but not as much as I was.
Oh, it's not so bad.
I think it'll be worse.
So if I'm not mistaken, you're part of HCR for this series?
Yeah, it's kind of a weird conglomerate between... Let's see, make sure I get this right. HCR, Warpath Racing with ORD. So I'm racing with HCR Solar, Windcharger, who you're probably familiar with, and then representing my ORD team, OnlineRaceDriver.com.
Okay, I was going to say, yes, I am familiar with Windcharger. He does commentary for us when he has time.
Yeah, when he has time. He also races for us when he has time.
Yes, there is also something else, but that'll be later.
Mm-hmm.
All right, gonna break away from you two for just a moment. See how the front's doing up in A class. Well, Skoda Boy has pulled ahead of Solar, and Contre Hurdle is still kind of stuck in the back.
Yeah, Hurdle and I are both kind of in. Well, there's a couple of guys that are about as fast as me, but Hurdle's kind of in an awkward position in this series where he's faster than a lot of guys, but then the top two he just can't quite catch. Even though he's really close by, he just can't quite catch them.
Well, the funny thing is, you could have the fastest car on your own. It's kind mm-hmm. of hard to keep up, especially when the top two are that close to one another, so they can push ahead.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a few racing series where first and second place are both teammates, so they can work together to push the car up in front ahead and then draft off of them. And then mm-hmm. third place is stuck because they don't have a drafting partner or they can't keep up into the draft line.
Yeah.
And again, I've seen drivers who don't have a drafting partner, and they can miraculously catch up if they find
yeah.
their breaking points. And of course, Shannon in the Mountain Dew, also sponsored by Nick.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is an
Nick.
Nickelodeon. Most points if you were a kid in the 90s.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is an interesting combination, both Nickelodeon and Montanu.
There's a joke to be here, to be made here about Hyper Kids, but it kind of tells itself.
Now, wasn't the story about this related to a Nick show? Or am I just completely overlooking it?
I'm not quite sure what you're referring to. Like, was there a Nick Mountain Dew show or something like that?
No, he did pick this as his childhood, or one of the sponsors from his childhood, and Mountain Dew is the main sponsor. I don't know either. Well, you can't really look it up because you have to close the app on Skype.
Yeah.
So yeah, we got John Galt in the Audi TT. It's not the fastest car, however, has managed to pull ahead of Gator, who's driving in the Leon seat.
And has the B-class cars quickly catching up to him.
He's taken one. Well, it's due to replay lag. Well, speaking of Class B, a Colonel leads with ELE Chief in second place. Now, what are the chances these two are going to put on a show for us again today?
I don't remember if they do or not. I don't believe they do. The Colonel's main problem is going to be this was a problem a couple weeks ago. Gator starts slowing down a little bit too much, so he actually starts getting in Colonel's way. It's kind of funny, actually. Funny to listen to, not funny to
watch.
Yeah. Well, it's still fun to watch because he's this tiny little Golf that's trying to pass the Satay, or however you say the name.
I call it a seat, but I'm sure someone else around the other part of the globe will say it's a Satay.
Yeah. These four Satays, I think there's a total of, there's a total of seven throughout the both the US and the UK versions of the series, and none of them are doing well.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Yeah, I think this is the way the build rules worked. It just favored the Scirocco and the Golf.
Well, speaking of lower tier class, we see Tyrannic Symbols in another Volkswagen.
But it is a Golf. And we have made so many what does the fox say jokes that it's no longer funny.
Well, it's because Joshua the Fox is not in this, then I'd be making more fox jokes. Yes.
Yes.
No.
No.
Okay.
You say yes, I say no.
Thing you can do, I can do better. Apparently.
I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Okay, stop.
Stop what? Let me get copyrighted. Stop the music.
You can't stop the beat. No. Stop before we get copyright claims. Anyway,
no,
Skoda, how is Skoda doing?
Okay, Skoda Boy is currently lead. However, if we are singing, we will not get hit with the copyright claims because we are not the rights owners. Well, we don't own. Yeah, this is our original content.
But what if it's so good that it gets flagged?
Oh dear, look, gracious me. We have two laps to go.
Now, Skoda is actually pulling pretty good on Solar at this point in the race. Solar's been doing